Hello. Now I shall be talking about types of constitutions and their features. There are four basic types of constitution. You have the written constitution, the unwritten constitution, the rigid constitution, and the flexible constitution. Now, the written constitution is that one where this body or set of rules and regulations are codified or put in one single document. Now, the features of a written constitution are one, like the definition, it is written in one single document. Two, it is rigid in nature. Three, the steps that can be taken to amend the constitution are written in that constitution. And four, it has a preamble. Let's consider some merits of a written constitution. It is easy to access and obtain. It is easy to reference in times of dispute. Three, it's easy to ascertain unconstitutional acts because everything is written in a single document. And four, it lets a citizen know his rights, his obligations, and when those rights and obligations, when those rights have been violated, and what to do when those rights have been violated. Let's consider the demerits of a written constitution. One, its rigid nature doesn't allow easy amendment of it. So whenever you want to amend it, it's usually cumbersome, that is tiresome and expensive. Two, it has to be amended all the time to meet future and present needs of a country. Three, it causes constant friction between the three arms of government. They are always clashing with themselves. And finally, four, it is very expensive to run. Now, there are some countries that practice written constitution, countries like the USA, United States of America, Nigeria, and France. Moving on to unwritten constitution. Now, written constitution is the direct opposite of written constitution. Here, all the rules and regulations are not written in a particular set or in a particular document. It's not codified in one document. It can be gotten from different sources. Now, an unwritten constitution is practiced in countries like New Zealand and Britain. Here are some merits of an unwritten constitution. It is not hard to amend. Steps to amend an unwritten constitution is not hard, so decisions can be taken more quickly. Two, it aids development of a country. But an unwritten constitution is bad in the sense that it's prone to abuse and can encourage dictatorship. And also, it's hard to ascertain unconstitutional acts in an unwritten constitution. In our next video, we shall be talking about a rigid and a flexible constitution.